US government has approved the world's first vaccine for honeybees.
The world's first honeybee vaccine.
To guard against American foul brood disease.
A few days ago, an article was released talking about the first ever vaccine that has been created for honeybees. So, of course, you guys all know me. I had to do some digging to figure out what this is all about. So, let's talk about it. It looks like the bees are active today. It is around 45 degrees, so they're working on cleaning out some dead bees. Okay, so as I said, this is the first ever vaccine that has been created for honeybees, and it has been created for American foul brood. So what is that? American foul brood is a bacteria that creates spores that can spread through an entire colony and cause it to collapse. It does this by infecting all brood that's 48 hours or younger, and it goes into the larva itself and starts replicating and ends up killing the larva. So adult bees, they are completely immune to it. The only way it can collapse a colony is by infecting the larva that's 48 hours or younger. So if the colony doesn't have any larva or any brood at all, then they're going to collapse because that's the only way they can reproduce. So it is something that has been known to be devastating to a colony. From what I was reading, it looks like the spores of AFB can actually live in a colony. It's once they hit a certain threshold, then it can completely take over the colony and cause it to collapse. So,
okay, hold on a second. Let me elaborate on this a little more. This is the study that they did on the vaccine, and in it, it says the data presented here indicate that infection with AFB can be decreased by about 30 to 50% in the laboratory conditions after vaccination of the queens. Interestingly, it has been shown that virulent spores are present even in asymptomatic hives, having an average of 158 spores per bee. However, an increase in spore loads to 30% can lead to a clinical outbreak of AFB. It was also found in studies that hives without clinical symptoms can have AFB spores up to a certain concentration. However, clinical symptoms will manifest and hives need to be eliminated when the spore level is increased by about 30% or more. All of this suggests that even a modest decrease in infection level will keep the disease from manifesting in hives. So all of this is telling me that we can have AFB spores in our colonies at any point in time. It's only if it reaches a certain threshold that we then start to see symptoms and it then becomes an outbreak.
I'm not really sure if that's something to do with genetics, and that may be why it is required for it to reach a certain threshold, because that kind of sounds like maybe the bees are somehow preventing it from sporulating. I don't know, but that's what AFB is. So what is the vaccine and how does it work? They have been studying this for, I read an article that was dated back to 2015, but this most recent one is a vaccine that contains an inactive bacterium of American foul brood that they add into queen feed and feed it to the queen. So the queen feed consisted of corn syrup and powdered sugar and this inactive bacterium. And what they did is they fed it to the queen bee, watched her, kept an eye on her, and then they introduced her to the colonies, and that's when the experiment truly started. So the reason they're feeding it to the queen is the queen is able to pass it on to the new eggs and the new brood through what's called transgenerational immune priming. It's a crazy cool thing that the bees do. They're able to be exposed to a pathogen or a virus and create some sort of immunity through that. And they do it through something called Vitellogenin, which you guys have heard me talk about before in my episode about varroa mites. And Vitellogenin is literally the backbone of bees and how they're able to survive. It's responsible for them being able to make it through the winter time because it's pretty much like a energy reservoir in their fat body that it allows them to be able to make brood food in the dead of the winter when they're trying to rear up brood in the spring, when there's absolutely no pollen left in the colony. And it also works by being a way of defining the social caste in a colony. So bees that live within the colony, they have a very high level of vitellogenin, but as a bee gets older, they have lower and lower levels of vitellogenin until they become a field bee. So another really cool thing, but the main thing I'm talking about today with vitellogenin is how it's responsible for performing a sort of immune system for the colony. So they're able to take in a virus or pathogen that they can get from infected brood that died. You'll see this in your colonies whenever you see brood that is like chewed down on. I've seen this so many times. And research says that usually when you see this, it's because that brood had deformed wing virus. So what they're doing is they're ingesting that virus or that pathogen and they're taking it into their body. And through vitellogenin and its transport, they're able to then put very small amounts of this pathogen into the brood food and feed it to the brood in a form of like a vaccine. This is some new research that we found in the last decade, which is crazy, crazy cool, because that means that the bees can in fact form immunity to pretty much anything. And it's something that they also found they're able to do with American foul brood. So because of this knowledge, that is how this vaccine works. They feed this infected queen feed to the queen, which then takes it in through her mouth and is able to transport it to the eggs through the vitellogenin transport so that the eggs can form some form of immunity to American foul brood. So I'll link the study below if you want to check it out and read the whole entire thing. It's super fascinating. So my thoughts on the whole entire thing though. Now, I absolutely love that this is the very first vaccine that we are trying to advance our technology in terms of trying to find ways to help our honeybees as a whole. This was the very first placebo-controlled double-blind study that they have done with honeybees for a vaccine. So there's still a lot of room to grow in that aspect, considering it was our very first study that we've done. So after learning about transgenerational immune priming, my main question is, do we need to add a vaccine to the bees when they're already forming one themselves? Now, this might be kind of counterproductive because, like I said, from what I was reading, there are spores that are in the colony at all times. It's not until it hits a certain threshold that they then become sick with American foul brood or even European foul brood. And then my next question is American foul brood even that common today? If you've ever had it, please drop in the comments. I would love to know just how common it is because I was trying to find that out and look it up, but that's definitely not something that's easy to find. But it's something that used to be prevalent back in the day that, like I said, it would wipe out colonies. So it makes sense why we're making this vaccine to help with our bees. But also, after reading the entire study, I don't really feel like there is enough evidence showing that it works, especially because by the way this study made it sound, this was the first time they ever performed it. So to all of a sudden approve this vaccine to start feeding to all of the bees, I'm kind of iffy on. Just because I feel like there needs to be more studies on it. There needs to be some studies looking at how it affects the queen itself and her efficacy. If she is still able to lay properly and do everything she needs to do in the colony without being affected whatsoever. But then also the thing that I mentioned about genetics. So if it takes a certain threshold for the bees to become sick with American foul brood, then that must mean that they are somehow managing the spores on their own, because that doesn't really make sense to me. Unless I know they're picking it up in other places as well, but I don't know. So would that just mean if we're feeding bees this vaccine that they are just weaker genetics and we're kind of doing the same thing we're doing with mites and trying to prop up weaker genetics? I don't know. I have so many questions. Just kind of telling you what's been running through my brain for this whole vaccine. But nevertheless, this is a huge accomplishment, the fact that we've actually came up with something like this and that we're doing the research to try to figure it out. And another thing that I did see in the experiment is the way they ran it is After the queen had been fed the vaccine and then introduced to the colonies, they then started removing brood that queen laid and took it into a laboratory. And that is where they then fed that larva food that was infected with American foul brood spores. And another thing that I was reading is that any sort of bacterium that sporulates, when you put it in a laboratory environment, it prevents it from sporulating. So I don't know if maybe this could affect also the results of the study and how everything turned out, because they were doing all of it in a laboratory instead of just doing it in a colony to see what happens, so that as it's exposed to all external factors, we truly see how it's going to perform in a colony. Because we're not going to be looking at these colonies in laboratories. We're going to be doing it in our colonies that are just exposed to the external environment and seeing what happens. So I kind of feel like it's pretty quick for them to completely approve this vaccine when there's still a lot of research that needs to be done before it starts being applied. Now, they may have just approved it. They might not be putting it on the market yet. I guess I probably should have looked into that as well. But anyways, I just wanted to make this super quick video talking about the vaccine that just came out, because this is super new tech in the world of beekeeping. So go check out that article. It's super interesting, and I'll see you guys soon.